University of Ohio State. Hey!
Hey!
Aw, oh, I don't want ball. That was good. Boom! I know they have a running back and a receiver. That's all I know. On that fast ass dude. Number 11. Oh shit! Get the ball! Alright, that's not the plan. Anyway. No.
And you've got his teammate Gene Hassis, first time Olympian in the pool here, just a couple of lengths away from Marshawn. So big moment here for the 24-year-old who swam collegiately at Texas A&M, now swims at UT.
You know,
Texas in Austin. Comes from military family, his mom Monica is pregnant with Shane while serving in the military, so this family very excited, and Shane is as well to represent his country. But Marshawn will get all the attention from this crowd. Second semifinal, lane 5, Diacento.
Go Hawks.
From Japan in lane 4, it is Stone Olympics.
Don't fumble. Fuck. No! Damn it! Fuck. Alright, whatever. Cheers!
Marshawn, that guy is fucking good, dude.
Who?
Gonna be like bro's third or fourth gold medal.
My way.
That's sense.
Oh, fuck. Come on, yo!
Yeah, he got first.
Oh
no, I didn't see.
All right, good sack.
I told him, I said at the beginning, he needed to be third.
Third.
Back to Marchand. Does he
have a
good job? Well, that's relevant. What I like about this, and this is what I want, Dan. Look at his face. His face is not tight at all. It's almost like he's gazing up to the stars. Oh, that's beautiful. He looks like he's gazing up to the stars on a beautiful era summer night. I mean, that's how good it looks right there. There's his vital torque. This is his go-to stroke. But wait a second. He doesn't have a go-to stroke. All four of them are go-to strokes. This guy's going to win the gold medal tonight. You don't want to miss it.
Shit.
Shit. Oh my god, dude. I should have just set my feet, bro.
Oh!
Every move and every stroke. Marchand continues to be the calmest guy in La Defense Arena. And he will lead the final eight into the field tomorrow for the medals. Foster, second best.
Alright. Come on, Texas!
We've got the big relay coming up. The women's.
Fuck, dude.
If you have advanced prostate cancer, you know all about perseverance.
Fucking ass, dude.
You believed in your team, even when it hurt. You met the challenge piece by piece. You didn't quit then. Don't start now. If you've had hormonal and chemotherapy, ask your doctor about Pluvicto, a different type of treatment for PSMA-positive metastatic prostate cancer that targets PSMA-positive cancer cells so you can be you for longer. And that's no small victory. Pluvicto involves contact with radioactivity, which may increase the risk of cancer and cause fatal harm. Drink plenty of fluids, urinate often, use contraception, and talk to your doctor about ways to reduce the risk of exposing others to radiation during and after treatment. Pluvicto can cause low levels of blood cell count, kidney problems, and infertility. Tell your doctor if you have weakness, pale skin, shortness of breath, bleeding, bruising more easily, an infection, or changes in urination. Side effects include tiredness, dry mouth, nausea, appetite loss, and constipation. Here's to never giving up. Ask your doctor about Pluvicto for more everyday victories.
What's with all the police trucks outside? This whole concert? It's a trap.
Come on, bro!
There's no way to stop them.
Stupid ass running back. Damn, bro.
Reach for core power and rise to a whole new level of recovery with high quality protein to build muscle so you can power on. Champion your recovery with core power. Proud partner of Team USA.
This is the women's 200 meter final.
Good block.
Good block.
Fucking 0-0.
Son of a.
The hell? Snap the ball.
Decky.
A dozen years now.
The whole
keeps on rolling along. So this night, another chance to distinguish yourself among the all timers. And likely to get a medal.
Oh my god.
My god.
No guarantee. The big gold medal favorites is Team Australia. Yeah,
they
should win at least 4 to 5 seconds. But it's going to be, as you said, a great race.
from silver and bronze. There are three teams vying for two medals. U.S., China, and Canada.
Australia's got the gold medal. Gold medalists, 100, 200.
Oh my God! Bro, just fucking throw it away. You moron, yours.
Hey, hey, hey.
I didn't know you
hey.
Could do that.
Ooh, the women's.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
Come on! Damn! Australia!
I like you too, girl. This stadium is fucking nice.
It is nice.
I've been.
You've been to it?
Yeah.
Quite way.
When I went on a field trip.
In our favorite rocket ship. Bro. Your D-line is insane.
Oh yeah, USA! Woo!
Swim, swim! Damn, Australia's fucking cooking.
I don't wanna be a fool for you. Hey! She hitting me. The formation is weird.
Fucking that first girl, fucking cussed.
Raja. What are you doing, dude?
Ledecky, let's see what she can do, bro. Holy shit. You say he's catching up.
Oh!
Whoa, shit! Go, Ledecky, go.
Are you looking for...
Happy National Spider-Man Day. Bro! Fuck, man!
Holy shit! Holy! Holy shit!
Holy fuck, dude. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on, holy shit. Oh my god!
Australia, the US in the second position, followed by China in the bronze medal spot. So it's up to Aaron Gemmell, who went to the same Stone Ridge school in Bethesda,
Maryland. No, go!
Guys!
That eighth gold medal in the 1500 meters
what set up this historic number 13. Of course, it's Michael Phelps who has the record overall with 28. But Kate Ledecky just stamped her own name in history, and so did Kate Douglas. She can now call herself an Olympic gold medalist. And Rowdy Gaines was there every nerve-wracking second of the race. Along with Elizabeth Beisel.
Can't say it. Calm down, buddy.
Well, Ledecky, though, bringing home Gemmell and bringing home Olympic medal number 13. Another incredible night at the pool, Mike.
No!
Great to see the performance by Katie Ledecky and the historical perspective that Dan was talking about. Now, 13 medals all time, the most decorated American woman in terms of medals in the history of the Olympics. Here is the stats to prove it. 13 gold medals won by USA women. She's got that record. Gold medals by a woman, 8. The record is 9. Katie's got another race that she is great in, the 800 free. Of note, the 13 only across all sports, summer and winter.
No!
Have gold medals. Slicing Katie Ledecky, one of the great Olympians of all time. Another race to come. We have beach volleyball still ahead. Some business to take care of. A lot more on what has been a terrific Thursday here in Paris.
Shit.
APR for 48 months plus $1,000 TFS subvention APR cash, or lease a new 2024 Tundra for just $4.99 a month.
Come in today.
Toyota, let's go places.
Listen, I spotted it from the start. Reagan didn't even have a name yet. All that potential just waiting to burst free.
Dude.
I think about every battle. Kids from the South Bronx who didn't just knock on the door, they kicked it in. And today, what I saw in us is the same thing I see.
Exciting competition day. It's still going on in Paris. We have live beach volleyball coming up in a few minutes. Do have a news item to share. Boxing, which has long been a popular staple of the Olympics, but has largely fallen off the radar recently, is making a lot of news around the world today. I want to give you some background before the news. This is the second straight Olympics where the IOC has taken over control of the boxing tournament. That's due to corruption and integrity concerns with the International Boxing Association. That's the Sports International Federation. So here, there are two boxers competing in Paris in the women's division who were disqualified by the IBA from the 2023 Worlds for what the IBA deemed competitive advantages over other female competitors. Their names, Algeria's Iman Khalif and Taiwan's Lin Yuting. The IOC said about them today they have been, quote, the victims of a sudden and arbitrary decision by the IBA after being, quote, suddenly disqualified without any due process. To explain, the IOC uses different regulations and said earlier this week that the boxers are, quote, entirely eligible. They are women on their passports. They've competed for many years as women. Khalif, who finished fifth at the Tokyo Games 3 years ago, had her first match in Paris earlier this morning against Italy's Angela Carini. Carini abandoned the match after 46 seconds after receiving several punches. Carini had this to say afterwards. I quote her, I am not one that easily surrenders. You all saw my nose that started bleeding. I didn't lose tonight. I just surrendered with maturity. When asked about her opponent, Carini added, I wish her to carry on to the end and that she could be happy. I'm not in the position of saying this is right or wrong. For their part, the Algerian Olympic Committee issued a statement tonight denouncing what it deemed unfounded criticisms of their athlete, Khalif. I want to take you back to 2021. The IOC issued this framework of fairness, inclusion, and non-discrimination on the basis of gender identity and sex variations. Key part of the first two sentences. It says, every person has the right to practice sport without discrimination and in a way that respects their health, safety, and dignity. At the same time, the credibility of competitive sport, and particularly high-level organized sporting competitions, relies on a level playing field where no athlete has an unfair, disproportionate advantage over the rest. So they're the facts. In Paris, all of this is playing out in real time. It's intersecting with the politics of international sport, politics in general, and the individual opinions that are being aired in the modern town square that is social media. As for the competition,
Khalif
is back in the ring on Saturday in a quarterfinal, and Lynn, the other athlete mentioned in question here, makes her Paris debut tomorrow. A reminder that we'll be back with you in prime time on your NBC station. Much more coverage and reaction to what we saw earlier today live here. Women's gymnastics, the all-round, where Simone Biles is back on top of the podium. Sweetly, bronze. It all starts at 8, 7 central on NBC. And we are 30 seconds away from more live action to the foot of the Eiffel Tower. One of the U.S. teams involved in beach volleyball, and they've got a hole to dig out. China's won the first set. We'll get you there for live volleyball as we continue on this Thursday night.
Folks, come on, pick the ball. Good move.
China with a nearly perfect first set. They win at 21-15 and led by as many as
No way. How did you get that off?
I'm him.
Why not? It's a party atmosphere here in Paris. Chris Marlowe, Mr. Bay.
Oh wait, I do get it. It's part of my antenna. Bro, I'm getting all these hits. But no, frickin'.
China scrambling. Nuss has another one. Close on two. Popped up. Turning. No.
Yeah, that's high.
Twister there. They couldn't quite come up with it. And that's just what the doctor ordered for this U.S. team, right? In the first set, everything.
Oh, shit.
Everything
oh, whoa.
Team at LSU.
LSU.
Now in the Olympics for the first time. That cross-court shot is just too good at the moment.
The Chinese
are
hit him.
Shui Chen, playing in her fourth Olympics. She's 35 years old. Shaw Shenye playing in her second Olympics. She's 27. Veterans and good players. Now, popped up. Blocked. Inside, Nuss has it. And the sweat.
Oh yeah, I got it. You hear it?
Homes.com.
What? Sway, try it again.
Why always the couch? Does he need to go to puppy school? Get a little puppy to put along. How much have I been spending on this little guy?
When your questions about life turn into questions about money,
woo!
The virtual financial assistant to help you spend.
Damn. Oh, he's playing volleyball. Is that the girls?
Yeah. USA.
Wait, are they up?
It just said in there.
Oh.
United States trying to battle back after
losing
the first set by 6-21-15. The Nuss cuts out. It is a second set. The Americans playing with a little bit more energy, a little bit more precision, and Kristen Nuss, after a slow start defensively, is starting to dig.
No!
USA don't block very much angle, so it really puts a lot of responsibility on Nuss running down those line shots. Cole, nobody else.
Why would you push him forward?
You know, this old school defense that Team USA plays, that's when all the greats have played, right? Karch Karai, Sinjin Smith, Ken Steffens. We're going to take the middle of the court away and we're going to give you the perimeters.
Oh, he was open.
Oh my god, dude.
This is all fucking great, dude. What's up, you loser? Hit him,
USA, Jared Cole.
Bombers. Good stop.
Fucking shit, dude.
Oh shit. Damn it. Oh!
This guy.
Oh my god. How many hit sticks are you gonna do? Flag?
Damn, she's 6'4".
She's tall as fuck, dude. She should play guard. What calls are these, dude? And you know, it is interesting because a lot of these players do wear glasses. I know a lot of clear lenses are worn at night, but that becomes a problem because they get wet, you can't see. A lot of them go off. 13-10, USA.
Off speed, got it. You know, Olympics. You don't put this combination together, right? The night match, you got the Eiffel on the side, you've got the rain coming down, you've got China playing nearly perfectly. And yet, here the U.S. is. They're just focused, they're taking care of their side, they're weathering the storm, literally and figuratively.
Here's Nuss. Nuss into the corner. Well, they need to mention the bright lights. And you've got a team playing in its first Olympics. We've seen what's happened to Sweden having some jitters. This Chinese team, very experienced. Now, Kristen Nuss.
No! Oh, I knew that was gonna happen. Motherfucker.
I fucking punched them in the face.
Bro, come on! Did he drop it? Motherfucker, dude. Why would you drop it? Bro, viewers! Fuck, man.
Part of the weather story here. See some flashing in the background. The United States has made a nice comeback here at set number two, however. They lead it 17-13. Renewed vigor from Kristen Nuss and Taryn Cole.
No way he's not in. That's some fucking bullshit. Can I challenge that? I don't think so.
Fucking USA is whooping ass.
Oh shit. Yo, come on. Good sack.
Tremendous placement there by Kristen Nuss. So the Americans 3 points away. Got it! Right in the corner. Nuss the ace.
Oh, shit. Oh!
I didn't see him.
Oh, there it is.
Nuss over the top. China's still alive. Nuss, get it! She's controlling. course. She played soccer. She was a player of the year in basketball. Obviously a volleyball star as well.
Renewed vigor for Kristen Nuss.
First set point for the United States. Gets the point back. So make it 20-16 now. Second set point coming up. Shaw will serve it. That means Shway is at the net. And that is the end of set number two.
Oh, shit. Damn, bro.
And final set. United States and China. In the pouring rain here in Paris.
No fucking way.
Oh
my god. You guys can't play deep. The one thing we didn't need. You guys do it. Fuck. Good shoot, Jules. Andale, shoot out! Leaves. Oh shit.
USA won. That's nice.
Oh. Good way to keep him in bounds. Holy shit. Man, they're doing good, bro.
Who?
USA.
The volleyball team?
Yeah. Wow. Well, you're in?
Yeah.
I need a sack.
Looked a little dumbfounded, but this is all for the safety of not only the players,
but the fans. Fucking rules.
title.
I'll give you an update as soon as I have one.
Third and final set.
You're right, the match has been delayed for sure. The Chinese making their way out. More in rain, lucking in the area. The United States is leading 3-2 in the third set. So this match gets an incomplete at the moment. The United States and China hopefully will continue.
Holy shit. Yes!
No! Fuck. Damn.
Oh my god, dude, I tried lobbing it. What the fuck, dude? Oh, stupid ass quarterback. Damn. That was good.
You know, it depends on the heaviness. He had a day. 5-1-38 and a 30. So probably more of a sense team hitting the net, maybe getting a dribble or flat down just like she did.
2-2. Third set down the line. Nuss is there. Can't see convert. Tries to. Over the net. Close right there.
See the stats. Viewers. Damn. This tight end.
Fuck, one of my receivers had 143 yards.
Damn, you threw seven picks?
Holy shit.